Experts are warning of an increase in people suffering with chronic fatigue syndrome through long COVID. It comes as those suffering urge the government to reclassify their illness so they can access the support they desperately need. Dewi Priest has a story.
Brewing a cuppa, a small task that for months was too much for Fiona Charlton.
May through to July, I was actually bedbound. The most severe I've been in over a decade.
She's one of around 45,000 people in New Zealand who suffer from ME, myalgic encephalomyelitis, or chronic fatigue syndrome.
I lost my 30s to this illness.
Collectively known as ME-CFS, it covers a number of post-viral diseases. Fiona only has the physical and cognitive capacity for a few productive hours each day, but others fare much worse.
Some of them actually require tube feeding because they can't eat on their own. So it is extremely disabling.
Just not a disability, according to the government. Instead, it's classified as a chronic illness, similar to diabetes.
Most people with diabetes can work full-time, they can earn money, they can interact with their society. ME-CFS is not like that. From the day of onset, you know, people are severely debilitated.
His daughter being one.
She went from being a vibrant teenager to not being able to walk for more than about 5 or 10 metres.
He's now one of the world's leading researchers and recently made the connection between these post-viral diseases and long COVID.
Long COVID is really a kind of an example of an ME-CFS type illness, and we've shown that in the research lab.
More long COVID cases could mean more people in Fiona's position.
Out of all the long COVID people, about 10% will actually fit the diagnostic criteria for ME. So that means at least another 20,000 people.
That's why she and others are lobbying government to reclassify ME-CFS as a disability and not a chronic issue. Doing so would give patients access to more resources and services. Their petition was read here at Parliament earlier this week.
We have asked for reclassification on a yearly basis for many years now.
Disability Minister Porter Williams says the timeframe for the ministry to deliver and transform disability support services is still to be determined, and any changes to eligibility would require more money.
It is a serious physiological disease, and we need the decision makers to recognise that too.
So the wait for change rolls on. Dewi Priest, One News.